The former CCW champion has certainly taken a dark turn as he enters the Riot ring once again, 1 week removed from his despicable turn on the OCW World Heavyweight Champion, Doc Green. Welcome to Riot 533, everybody. I'm Jake, speaker man himself. I am happy to be back in the booth, especially for what is certain to be a heated contest. Antonio Everrett, the best friend of the man that B17 betrayed 1 week ago, certainly fired up to get his hands on the former CCW World Champion. B17, much less colorful, much less enthusiastic, much less fan-friendly. Somebody who has no trouble getting along with the fans. It's time to bounce! One half of the uncrowned, your light heavyweight champion, Antonio Everrett.
They say I'm lucky, I must be fucking lucky. Already paid my dues and they running out of money. Got different point of views, you should see a man, they lovely in my prime. Should be running for the country, instead I keep it gully. Hoods on in the restaurant, elbows on the table, but my Stan Smith's on my trousers down low. I still be.
That's two R's and two T's for you, keeping count at home. AE, ready to get revenge on B17 tonight in the main event of Riot 533. The final Riot before the grandest stage, the biggest show, the greatest show, Resolution.
Let the liquor pour out, let the ladies all drown. We be going soaking, how we gonna walk out? Fucking up my liver, treat my body like a whorehouse. Used to be a Christian, now I'm in the your wild.
B17 making his intentions known last week. He lost the CCW World Championship on Turmoil in that fatal four-way, and he immediately sets his sights on the OCW World Championship held by none other than the rookie sensation, Doc Green. B17 and Antonio Everrett in action tonight. We're going straight into it. Ted is your official as always. Let's do it! B17 going quick in with the strikes, not able to take advantage. Antonio Everett, a much bigger guy than his tag team partner, Doc Green. Big Samoan drop from the wily Brett. And now some jabs using that spider-like length to reach the midsection of B17, taking him out with a shoulder tackle. And now we're going belly to belly. Down goes B17. Antonio Everett holds all of the cards early in this one. Until a spine buster. That's one way to change the momentum in your favor. B17. That signature spine buster. Now following it up with some devastating strikes. There's another big uppercut. Antonio still hasn't left his feet. Gonna go for a big slam. No. Antonio Everett quickly countering. And follows it up with a nice gut buster. B17 not the same man we saw towards the beginning of this season. The man that we saw looking to take down Rex. A head full of hair and a beard now, and looking rather dark and mysterious is B17. Antonio Everett really working that shoulder, trying to take away one of the limbs. Here's a quick cover, trying to sneak up on the champion, the former CCW champion. Everett's been waiting for this moment. And once again, B17 laying a dropkick on him. He didn't go down. He did the second time. Watch the dropkick, rookie. Laying another strike on him, but Antonio Everett just shaking it off. Not a lot you could do to shake off a whiplash-inducing spine buster as he drops the Riot rookie back to the mat once again. Now he's got him by the neck. Gonna try and take him into the corner. No! Antonio Everett said, I don't want to go to timeout, sir! Couple of shots to the midsection, and he is back in control. And now the flurry of strikes from those spider-like limbs! The tarantula! Antonio Everett! Taken down B17, and he's going to follow it up with a senton splash. And another quick pinfall. We'll see how far Ted gets the cover. Just a one count. And Everrett. Oh, discount cutter! Before I can even continue! And he'll follow it up with a fist drop! A lot of damage to the head there on that sequence from B17. Taking a page out of the Invictus handbook. Out of the Austin Lee handbook. The discount cutter. And Antonio Everrett has had his own conflict over the past couple of weeks. Although much less muted than the B17 Doc Green affair. Antonio Everrett set to take on AC Cobra at Resolution for that light heavyweight championship. Both of these men have their hands full coming into the biggest show of the year. One for the world heavyweight title, one for the light heavyweight title. But right now, they've got their focus, their sights set on one another. Oh, man, wrenching the arm and taking him down with a back suplex. Antonio Everrett, the master of strikes. One of the masters of strikes. And it's a very good strategy from B17 to take out one of those arms, one of those weapons. Big clubbing blow to the back. Nice reversal. And once again, the back and forth, the strikes. Went for, looked like a discount cutter of his own, to no avail. Reverse power slam! Dropping Antonio Everrett chest first into the mat. Not a lot of safety there from B17, and he's going to follow it up. Whipping Antonio into the corner and following up. Ah, with some vicious chops to the chest. What does he have in mind here? Cueing it up, Antonio still groggy, taking two big B17 boots! To the chest, going back into the turnbuckle, but it's only going to be enough for a one count. Both of these men as resilient as they come here in OCW. Everett finally getting back to his feet. B17 now exiting the ring. Maybe trying to catch his own breath. Everett, he's back up. He's ready to fight. Here comes the Bingo Bomber. Everett wasting no time, going right back to the Gutbuster Well. Intercepting B17 the second he came into the ring. And now Everett catching B17 with a wake up. Now several shots to the midsection, really trying to punish that lower abdominal area. Now once you have a mud belly to belly over the top rope. That'll rearrange your insides in a hurry. B17 dumped to the outside over the head of Antonio Everrett. The unforgiving, albeit padded, floor below. But the Bingo Bomber right back to his feet. Everrett holds all of the momentum right now. We'll see if he can maintain it going forward. And this time, B17 going to get the jump on him. Diving in with a quick rushing attack as soon as he enters the ring. Everrett once again using those limbs. And an exploder suplex. Bit of a Northern Lights variation. Dropping B17 down on his back. You can see him wincing, holding the lower back. Maybe a little bit of, maybe playing a little possum there. B17, a chop across the chest. And once again, Antonio Everrett showing his strength, not going down. And quickly following up with some strikes and a diving, sliding clothesline. The British Pete Townsend, the Tarantula. Here's the cover. Just a one count after the sliding clothesline. Everrett brings his opponent back to his feet. And now some quick jabs, some quick strikes. Two of the most proficient strikers in the entire OCW Federation. Right now, here we go. Diving right on top of him. A bit of a Luthez press. Several shots to the face. And now Everrett, not done yet. Crafting some imagination with that move, dropping B17 once again unceremoniously to the mat. Playing to the crowd now is Antonio Everrett, and now both men seated in opposite corners, but Everrett, the one that doesn't need to catch his breath. B17 trying to buy a little time, maybe. We saw this before. He was playing possum. See if it's that way. Ah, Everett was ready for it this time. He's not going to dive in. B17 runs right into a dropkick. And now Everett getting the Bingo Bomber to his feet. Snapmare coming and a dropkick to the side of the head. Down goes B17. And this is a bingo that we have not seen in some time. Really the polar opposite of the B community leader that we've known to love. Right now he's feeling like the fans, notably of people like Doc Green and Antonio Everrett, Valkyrie, have betrayed him, have not appreciated him. And that was his explanation as to why he took out Doc Green 1 week ago. Look at this, a sharpshooter. What an incredible move, putting more pressure on the back of B17. Oh, and somehow Bingo able to fight out using the lower body strength, pushing his way out of the submission maneuver and right into a front face lock. A Cesarean uppercut, and he's gonna follow it up. Looked like a Uranagi slam, but instead focusing on the back of Antonio Everrett. And now, just like that, Bingo drops an elbow to the heart of the light heavyweight champion. Is that going to be enough? Dangerous elbows from B17. Antonio not interested in staying down for a pinfall after that maneuver. Everrett crawling, hoping. He was really delivering most of the punishment of this match in the last few minutes. And now Bingo out of nowhere! That's a Bingo punch! Antonio didn't scout him well enough! Here's the cover two! It's just a two count! Antonio Everrett kicking out of the famed Bingo punch. Amazing resiliency shown from the rookie. And now B17... showing that more of that unhinged nature, grabbing a weapon from outside. But he does think better of it, puts it down. Oh, that's because he wants a steel chair. We saw last week Ashley Moore get disqualified in her match. Antonio's not going to let it happen. He wants to win this straight up. Throws the chair away, catches him. Oh boy, whose favorite knee is it? Yermaz to the chin of B17. He was too caught up in the anger of the kickout. He tried to get him with that chair, and Antonio Everrett got him. That's a three count. Your winner, revenge for the uncrowned Antonio Everrett.